Every morning at the mine, you could see him arrive. He stood 6'6" and weighed 245. Kind of broad at the shoulder and narrow at the hip. And everybody knew he didn't give no lip to Big John. Nobody knew where John called home. He just drifted into town and stayed all alone. Didn't say much, just kind of quiet and shy. And if he spoke at all, he just said hi to Big John. Somebody said he'd come from New Orleans, where he got in a fight over a Cajun queen and a crashing blow from a huge right hand sent a Louisiana feller to the promised land. Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big John.
There came that day way down in the mine when the timber cracked and men started crying and miners were praying and hearts beat fast and everybody thought they'd done breathe their last, except John. Through the smoke and the dust of this man-made hell walked the giant of a man that the miners knew well. Wrapped a sack of timber and gave out with a groan, and like a giant old tree just stood there alone, Big John.
Big John, Big John,
Big Bad John.
With all of his strength, he gave a mighty shove, and a miner hollered out, "There's a lion up above!" And his 20 men scrambled from a would-be grave. Now there's only one left down there to save, Big John. With jacks and timbers, they started back down, and then they heard a rumble way down in the ground, and the smoke and gas belched out of that mine. Everybody knew it was the end of the mine for Big John.
Big John, Big John,
Big Bad John.
They never reopened that worthless pit. They just put a marble slab over it. These few words are written on that stand. At the bottom of this mine lies one hell of a man, Big John.
Big John, Big John.